Welcome to Shot of Agua. I'm Ellen Galloy. This show was created to honor those who've dedicated their time to the students of the mass and corporate communication departments at Buena Vista College. Tonight, we will contextualize the people who have made great impacts on our lives. First up, In Impact, our segment that examines life in all forms, gives you a glimpse of logging nightlife. Here's to the midnight hour.
Today on Impact, Mike Miller retains the title of one of the quietest, not to mention shortest, teachers on the campus. Fellow teachers, when asked about him, decided to break the wall of silence surrounding this issue and spoke out on Miller.
Nope, don't know about him. Never hear him talk. Kind of a quiet guy.
I never heard him talk either.
Well, can we trust the guy?
I just don't like him. Never heard him talk. He's a mute.
We intrepid reporters here on Impact decided to follow him and find out how one of the quietest teachers on the campus could possibly be a radio production professor. The answer will shock you.
Mike Miller, the voice of the 60s. Groovy, man. Groovy.
Next on Impact, Bowers Ellingson Mud Wrestling. Be there.
Stay tuned for sports.
I used to be a professor in the mass communication department at Buena Vista College, but I just didn't have what it took to fit in around there. When I read in the newspaper that the position was opening back up, I decided to apply. But this time, I brought my secret weapon with me.
I just don't know, Paul. Do you think it'd really be a good idea to have Andrea come back? I mean, she didn't fit in the last time she was here.
I know. There's something the matter with her. You know, plus I'd have to get all that shit out of there at the office. Damn.
Well, that wouldn't be a problem. I could have my academic assistant take care of that. Well, then again, that could be a problem.
Bruce, here she comes.
Hi, Andrea. Great to see you.
Hi, how are you? Paul? Bruce?
Please sit down.
We're really looking forward to having you come back.
Thanks. I'm getting excited about it myself.
Yeah, I was just telling Bruce here how we were cleaning out your office yesterday.
Well, that's not quite like you, getting on top of things instead of procrastinating.
She's a kidder.
Yeah. You've really changed, Andrea. Well, what have you done?
I used my secret weapon. It helped me, and it can help you too. Beard Club for Women. I'm not only the president, I'm a member.
Now, here's a look at bicycle racing fraud. Here's to 50-year-old bikers.
Bicycle racing fraud is a growing concern among competitive cyclists. As you can see here, Bruce Ellingson and Lookalike will exchange many times throughout this race around the lake. As one competitor goes to rendezvous point by bicycle, the other follows in his car. Here, they meet at their second rendezvous point. One of Ellingson's competitors, Nate Smithy, said that Ellingson's actions were, quote, like something I would do. Doesn't he have any ethics, morals, or at least common sense? After this last exchange, Ellingson proclaimed victory.
Yeah! Here's a clip from a movie that has been on Billboard's top movie rental list from the last 4 years. Here's to Alana's Laugh.
Oh, you.
After this break, we'll bring you Words from the Wise.
Bruce Ellingson, professor by day, renegade by night, Reno, cologne for men, set the renegade free.
Now, words of wisdom from Buena Vista College's wise old owl. Here's to the old Hoot Hoot himself.
I know some of you may have heard this story once before, perhaps even twice, but it demonstrates the importance of the sender and receiver having communicated effectively. Something you can share with your cronies if you want. Ivan Harlan's daughter was teaching at school one day, and there's only one pair of boots left in the classroom and one child. So she helped the child put on the boots, and after the shoes were on, she asked the child if these were his boots. The child replied, no. So the teacher took off the child's boots and looked all around the classroom, but couldn't find any other boots. She then asked the child what boots he had worn to school that day. The child pointed and said, those boots. Teacher said, but I thought you told me those weren't your boots. The child looked at the teacher and said, they're not. They're my sister's. Well, that just goes to show that you've got to communicate effectively to get your point across. Well, see y'all later. Miss Galloy, take care of yourself. I'm off to my bowling meet tonight.
Shot of Agua now gives you the debut song off of this boy's new album. Now, here's the video from Grammar Boy, the funky diva of grammar.
The Grammar Boy swears he is a diva. The Grammar Boy's got it all under control. Always spelling, always quoting. The Grammar Boy is creating your goal. The Grammar Boy always has a verb. The Grammar Boy wears the most expensive tweed. The Grammar Boy is with never without word. Where the money comes from, the fame only knows. I am the Grammar Boy.
I'm Bruce.
I am the Grammar Boy. I am the Grammar Boy.
I'm Bruce.
I am the Grammar Boy. The Grammar Boy lives off sentence structure. The Grammar Boy's got it all under control. A very, very dubious lecture. It's the tack, no doubt. The Grammar Boy's whole life is subject. Others change the grammar rules or add new case. But if one does, there's no need to worry. Another G-boy can't take my place. I am the Grammar Boy.
I'm Bruce.
I am the Grammar Boy. I am the Grammar Boy.
I'm Bruce.
I am the Grammar Boy. Boy has rules to follow. The Grammar Boy just needs words to play. But just like words you can't pronounce by edit, meaning catches up and you have to say. The grammar boy is always on the cone list. You'll always find him in his tweet and shades. He'll be your friend if you have when words collide. If you don't, he won't communicate. I am the grammar boy.
I'm Bruce.
I am the grammar boy. I am the grammar boy.
I'm Bruce.
I am the grammar boy. I am the grammar boy.
I'm Bruce.
I am the grammar boy. I am the grammar boy.
I'm Bruce.
I am the grammar boy. What do you mean my grammar's no good?
That's all for this year. I'm Ellen Galloy for Shot of Agua. Here's to the class of 1994.